All right, hi guys. We're live for the kids' class today. Okay, we're going to start with a warm up. If you see this later, right, you can play it and rewind it. So, jumping jacks first. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good. Squat position. Make sure this is on. Okay, there it is. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good squats. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. You could do more than 10 if you want. This is just a quick warm-up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good. Check it out. Stretching. Arms first, right? Forward, back. Hip rotations. Circling. Circle the knees. Stretch down. These are straight. All right, so this is just overview. You can go at your own pace. So always make sure you get a little warm up. Okay, let's go into our stance, right? Big toe to back heel. Put your strong hand forward. Good, elbows are in, chin is down. So we're gonna focus on punches into kicks. Okay, so first what we're gonna do is jab cross. Pendulum hook kick, right? So the way to do this is turn on the cross so you can slide in. Jab, cross, slide. And round kick or hook kick, right? Jab, cross, and slide. And make sure to slide the feet together. Jab, cross. Pendulum hook kick, right? If you have a punching bag, you could do this on a punching bag, or you can do a shadow boxing, which is practicing in the air. Okay. So I'll also demonstrate on the kickboxing bag over here, the long bag. And you can put on gloves if you have boxing gloves. These are more black bag gloves or MMA gloves where you can grab just to protect knuckles, hand, wrist. Okay, so same combination, right? Jab, cross, pendulum hook kick. So hands are up here, punching straight in the center, and then just sliding into the pendulum hook kick or round kick, right? Straight punches, forward, back, slide. Right, the slide brings you in fast to land that round kick or hook kick. It brings you really quick, boom, to throw that kick. Again, jab, cross, pendulum hook kick, and then you move around a little bit, okay, so you're not stationary. Hands are here, elbows are in, jab, cross, which is two straight punches, right? Head level, jab, cross, pendulum hook kick, by sliding in. Okay, a couple more, jab, cross, pendulum hook kick. Okay, good. Let's go into a different combination. All right, we're gonna go into jab, cross, hook. Rear hook kick or rear round kick. Jab, cross, lead hook, rear round kick or rear hook kick. Punching straight, punching around, and kicking at the leg. Jab, cross, lead hook, rear hook kick. Okay? Turning our body. when we punch. We turn our hips and we turn our feet. We rotate with our body. And that gives us more power. Okay? Very important when striking. So, hands are up here, elbows in, chest cross, and rear hook kick to the left. Get up in front of you. Jab cross, lead hook. Two straight punches, one punch that goes around, rear hook kick to the leg. Turn your body, turn your hip. So the kick, right? I'll do it from this angle. Open your hip up. Bam. Hitting with your shin bone to a soft target, thigh or knee. Jab cross, hook. One more time. Jab cross, hook. Rear round kick. Okay, very good combination. Next one. Okay, we're going to throw a knee strike. We're going to point our foot back and go straight in. Okay, so we'll do the punches first and then throw in the knee strike. So we're going to go jab. Or straight lead hook, right? Lead hand straight, lead hand going around. Jab hook. Rear knee, right? Back leg, come straight in, and you're pointing your foot down so you can have a sharp knee going straight in directly to your target, right? So we're aiming at the belly, or if there was a pad or a bag, right? Aiming at the center. So, jab, hook, rear knee. And I bring that knee back into the stance. Sometimes you can knee and step in for a takedown. Okay? Or sometimes you can knee and throw an overhand punch, right? So there's several options with that combination. Jab, hook, rear knee, I come back here and recover, or I go jab, hook, rear knee, I step in for takedown, or jab, hook, rear knee, I step in with an overhand punch where my elbow comes up and I just turn my body like I'm throwing a ball and all my force goes into it. Okay, so let's try that combination where we're switching our lead for a split second. Jab, hook, rear knee, step in, overhand punch. Three. Slower, jab, hook, rear knee, I step in. See all that force into that punch, right? Think of like you're throwing a ball and you just modify. Your elbow comes a little higher this time. And you just turn your body. I step and I pivot. I step and I pivot for power for that overhand punch. Okay? So from the beginning, good stance. Back heel is off the ground. Jab hook. Now notice how I missed, right? That might happen sometimes. You miss the focus mitt, you miss the bag. It happens. So if I miss, make sure to recover. I don't want to miss it. Oh, I missed. I have to recover right away. Very important. Okay? So jab, hook, bam, step in. A little faster. Jab, hook, overhand, right? Rear knee into overhand. Front hand. One more time. Digging with the overhand punch. Very effective, very strong combination. Let's see, any comments from you guys? Okay. Very well. Okay, so let's throw. Again, punches into kicks, right? That's our theme for now. So we're gonna go jab into that same overhand punch. And we're gonna throw a hook kick with the rear leg, right, going to the body. If you don't kick that high, kick down to the leg. Okay? Jab. Overhand punch, or it could be a cross, right? And throw the rear hook kick. Right? So again, you can move your head as you do it. Front hand. Step out and move your head away from the bag or the target. As you do that, bring your kick up with your shin bone, right? Okay, if you can kick higher, I like to kick higher sometimes. You can do that. Let's move around and throw a bunch of combinations, and then we'll set up the kick, all right, with a feint or a fake. So just gonna work punching only for about 10 seconds. Right, so I'm just boxing the person up, or sparring, wherever you're training, or just shadow boxing, right? Hitting with your punches, straight combinations, uppercuts, whatever you want to throw, overhand. As long as your elbows are in and your chin is down, you have a better chance of not getting countered, okay? So we're here in this position, firing good punches, moving our head, and then all of a sudden, I fake high with my hands, and I kick low, okay? So I'm doing this also with movement, call it lateral movement, so moving either to this side or that side, going forward or back. All right, so being very alive and not in a stationary position where I can get hit a lot more. Okay, so it's better to be moving, because with motion there's no style, right? It's all biomechanics and science. So here, moving on our toes, lateral movement, using the bag, that's what I'm using, right? So I'm just gonna move around the back as I'm firing combinations. Good, now I'm gonna fake into a low kick, right? Fake it. Low kick, punches at the higher level, right, to the head, and then attacking low at the legs, right? So let's do a different combo, throwing punches to set up kicks, right? So now we're going to throw a double jab, which is a fast, snappy combination. Okay. So it's going elbows in here, two punches to your lead hand, and make it where your shoulders are loose, and your arm is nice and relaxed, so it can be fast. All right, so this is a stiff jab. Notice a lot slower than double jab where it's snappy. All right, same thing here, stiff jab. All right, maybe it has more power. And snappier jab. And so it's more explosive. Okay, so body relaxed. And just explode with the two punches with the lead hand. Okay? Very nice and easy. Okay, so what we're gonna do is double jab, rear hook, lead hook. So this combination goes different levels. Double jab up top, rear hook to the body, lead hook to the head. And we're gonna finish with a low kick like before. Okay? So two jabs to the body, okay? Head, body. Finishing with that kick, right? Same thing, a little faster. Working with movement. Moving your head also moving your feet. Lateral movement, rolling, slipping, in and out, footwork. Keeping yourself very alive and on your eyes, focusing on where you're hitting. Let's do more longer range, okay? So straight lead, right? Straight lead into pendulum front kick. If I'm hitting the back, I wanna use a correct front kick by placing it with the ball of my foot. This way I don't kick with the top of my foot on the bag because then it's gonna hurt my foot. It's gonna bend it in. So I'm gonna use the ball of my foot, bottom of my foot to land on the heavy bag, okay? Because it's not like a person, it's not exactly like a person where someone's standing like this and you kick straight up, the top of your foot's gonna hurt because you're hitting a very sensitive area. The bag doesn't feel anything, so I have to kick it right straight, and plus the way it's shaped, I cannot kick it with the top of my foot, right? So straight lead into pendulum front kick with the ball of your foot, right, on your toes. Ball of your foot, not your heel. Right? Straight lead, right? Vertical punch, going straight in. And using your front kick, right? The leg that's in front, ball of your foot. And so knee lifts, kick straight in. The knee lift is where you'll find your target. The knee points, and you shoot your kick out. So, same thing, straight lead, pendulum front kick. Moving our head. Ball of your foot. Notice, push and slide. That's pretty fast, right? Slowly. Push in. Slide in with your knee. Push in and slide a little faster. Let's work on a new combo, all right, where we're gonna clinch. So punches, clinch, knee. And we're gonna go here. Fire again, the lead hand. Use the lead hand to set up your other punches. So that's your jab or straight lead. Okay. We're here, moving our head. Working a double jab with the lead hand, double jab. Grab the bag on top. If you don't have a bag, just use the air. Double jab, grab one at a time. One, two, and push out. Okay, so that's a good recovery. So we're here, double jab, right? Ooh, you time it, you grab, elbows in. One, two, push out with one hand. Okay, this is good on the recovery. If you ever sparred a little bit and you work some grappling with punches and kicks, you'll see it. If you grab someone and you start doing knees and stuff, right? And again, when we spar, we don't go very hard with the knees. But especially for the kids, we only spar a boxing in the beginning, right? Once they get a little older towards high school, they move up to the adult class. And then we do more kicks and punches, sometimes knees in the clinch, right? So either way, for self-defense, it's good to know. Okay, so double jab, right? Grabbing one, two, elbows in, controlling, one knee, two knees, and I'm gonna push with my front hand. This way, when I finish the knee strikes, I don't stand in front of someone because then I can get hit back, right? So two jabs, grabbing one at a time, because if I grab here, I open my body or my face up, and again, I don't want to get hit, right? So double jab, grab once, grab the second time with the other hand, right? Two knee strikes, and I push with the front hand so I can create space, okay? So nice and easy, little slow in the beginning. Two jabs, slip, grab, lead hand, control, grab rear hand, control, elbows in. Make sure you have grip here, not interlocking your fingers. Palm over palm, palm over your hand. Okay, so never interlocking like this. Cup your hands. Creating space at the end. Very important, right? For grappling, for martial arts, for striking too. Okay? So, double jab again. Grab the front hand, back hand. One at a time you grab. Never like this, because even for grappling, if I'm wrestling with someone and I go like this, they're gonna duck, grab my legs, and take me to the ground. Same thing applies. When you're wrestling, right, you're not going like this with both hands because you're going to open yourself up. Same thing applies when you're striking too. Front hand, back hand, one at a time. Right, again, if I do this, I open up my center line. Very dangerous for me. Okay, double jab, one at a time. Grabbing lead hand, rear hand. One, two. Push and create space. Super, super important. Because again, if I don't create space and I finish here without any stopping power, right, then I'm gonna get hit back, right? So I don't wanna get hit back, create space and push out and make it safe. So one more time, double jab with the lead hand. You can slip and grab. Grab hand, one, two, controlling without interlocking our fingers. Two knees. Step one foot back. Step your other foot back. Push off one hand and create space by pushing and moving yourself back. Right? If the person's bigger than you, you're not going to stand here and go, oh, and try to push them if you're not as big as them, right? You might not have that strength. There's always someone stronger or bigger. So I create space by pushing and moving myself. Right? That's a safer way. Okay, getting out of the way, creating that distance. Right? So again, double jab, grabbing. One, front hand, two, rear hand. Knee straight in, step back. A little faster. Good. Let's add a rear kick. Create space, rear kick. Three. Same thing, just adding a round kick or a hook kick. Okay. Same combination. Double jab. Grab one, grab two. Two knee strikes, create space. Throw a round kick or a hook kick. The same. Jab, front hand. Grab it. One, two knees. Boom. Create space with the lead hand. Boom. Throw with your shin, attacking the thigh. Okay. Different combo, right? Hook cross. So we're going to start with the lead hook from the start now, without the jab, right? Maybe we landed the jab, so we're going to slip and throw a lead hook, cross, rear knee. Okay, on the half beat, which makes it faster for me, okay? So hook, cross, slow, lead hand, back hand going straight, and the knee will come right behind the cross. So I'm not going to go across, wait a little bit, and then knee. In the beginning, I might do that for form, but if I want to have a faster combination, I will throw it on a half beat motion. Okay, so hook, cross, and the knee travels right behind the cross, okay, without waiting. Okay, so I'll do it full beat, right? One full beat, so you see the difference. Hook, cross. I'll even do that faster. Okay, full beat, where I come back, and then I go again. Half beat. Right away. So there's no waiting. As soon as I throw the cross, I put my force, my power, I twist into it, throwing the cross. As I do that, the knee falls right behind. So I'm throwing two strikes with the same rotation. Think of it that way. Okay. Here. Throwing two strikes on that same rotation of the hip. Turning the hip, turning the foot. Right, power with your body. All right, one more time. Last one, right? Half beat. Slip, right? Working head movement. Hook. Touch with the cross. Just throw the knee. Think of throwing a hard knee. Finish with a hard knee. Don't worry about the punches too much. The punches are for a distraction to land the knee. One. Okay, so throwing punches into kicks and using some full beat and then going towards half beat to make faster combinations, right? Don't forget, you warm up, turn your body when you strike, have your hands up, your elbows in, your chin down, solid stance where you have balance, right? And don't forget, keep training and we'll open up eventually, right? Just stay safe and we'll see you guys next time. We're going to be live for the adult class coming up right now at 4 o'clock. Okay? So see you kids next time.